Alright, we're talking about anamorphics and I'm using the 24mm f2.8 on a Weeble S on a7 III camera, and I'm just about to test this. I thought I'd combine it with a bit of a vlog. The camera is approximately, I don't know, 1.5 meters away from me, so you're getting this kind of wide angle view. If I was to go towards the camera and point it towards me, this will be as if I'm holding the gimbal. In fact, I'll do that now. And as you can see, I'm slightly out of focus, so I'm just going to adjust for that. Yep. So hopefully you'll get the sense of me vlogging with this camera as I'm just about pointing it towards myself. I'm just gonna put it down horizontally, and this is the view. As you can see, we've already got a Chinese junk, the famous one with the red sails, although the red sails are not on, and it's a gorgeous sight. So I'm just gonna let you scan that as I show you the area. Bit blurry considering I'm in focus. I'm just gonna turn it around and hopefully you'll get to see a wonky version of Hong Kong. Hang on. It's not so easy to operate single-handed, so I'm just gonna take this off, double tap on it, and hopefully get everything in focus.
Standing, always so quiet, we're like elevators filled up with strangers. No sound, no hallelujahs, still I was praying on the train ride home. If I can get the things I want, I can get the things I want, just give me what I
So, yeah, I mean, what can I say about this lens? It's definitely a nice lens for the gimbal. I don't see much of a walking bounce, but you have to be really careful. And it's classed as a 24mm on the APS-C format, but it's really a 36mm on full frame. At least that's how I see it anyway. So you do see a bit of wobbles, but it's minimal, so I reckon you can get away with it. But if you really wanted to do cinematic shots like this, you'd probably want to try to keep really steady and probably do the old trick of doing slow-mo footage by using higher frames per second and then playing it normally on the editor. When compared to the 35mm anamorphic, the flares and the bokeh rendering are much superior on the 35mm than the 24mm. This can't be helped because the lowest aperture value for the 24mm is f2.8. Increase the bokeh rendering would increase the overall price of the lens itself. From my experience, it's best to use the 24mm for gimbal shots and tracking, and then interlace your video with a 50mm or 35mm, which has a better bokeh rendering. Overall, I think the 24mm makes a brilliant gimbal lens, but filming with just the 24mm alone would make the overall video a bit uneven. So it makes sense that you would use all three lenses, or at least two of them, just to make a decent anamorphic video. Anyway, I'm going to finish off here and hopefully you get the gist of this vlog. It's basically me trying to talk to the camera while trying reviewing this camera, this lens, sorry. I'm going to shoot off. Like and subscribe to this video and I'll talk to you later. Hopefully more about drones or anamorphics. Cheers. Bye.